Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are well at your home. And now I welcome to you all in this online class video. This is the fifth part of the fourth chapter, parts and wholes of class 5 subject mathematics. And before starting the video, I request to the all viewers to like, share and subscribe my channel. Let's start the class. At first, let's know the topics of today's overview. So we have 5 topics. So the first is rupees and paise. The second is an old woman's will. Third is Arun's timetable. Fourth is school magazine. And at last, we have Sleeping Beauty. Now come to the first topic, which is rupees and paise. First of all, you will tell me what is the symbol of Indian rupees. Yes, do you know this? How to write the symbol of Indian rupees? Let me tell you. First of all, you have to write Ra. Yes. Okay, then you will take a cross. So this is the symbol of Indian rupees. You can make it easily. Okay, this is for your knowledge. Now come to the topic. How many 50 paise will make 1 rupee? Is 50 paise half of 1 rupee? So here is a question related to rupees and paise. So first of all, you have to know about rupees and paise. So 1 rupee 1 rupee makes 100 paise. Clear? You have to know this. 1 rupee makes 100 paise. So here is a question. How many 50 paise, this is the coin of 50 paise, will make 1 rupee? So you can easily write that 250 paise makes 1 rupee. Because when you will add 250 paise, you will get 100 paise. 50 paise plus 50 paise, you will get 100 paise. And 100 paise makes 1 rupee. And second is, how many 25 paise will make 1 rupee? For that, what you will do? Actually, in the first question also, and in the second, you have to divide 100 paise with 25. So you will get 25, 4 ja, it is 100. So 4 times, okay, means 4 coins of 25 paise will make 1 rupee. Similarly, you can find that how many 50 paise, so you have to divide it. You will write 50 is your divisor and 100 will be your dividend. So 100 divided 50 paise. So 52 ja 100. So you are getting 2 coins of 50 paise. Why we are dividing this all? Because here is a fraction, 100 paise divided by 50 paise. So here you can see that we have a fraction number, and fraction means division. For that we are dividing this all numbers. Now next we have 25 paise is dash part of 1 rupee. So we found that if we will add 4 times 25 paise, so we are getting 1 rupee. So we can write that 25 paise is 1/4 part of 1 rupee. Now here we have 20 paise is what part of 1 rupee? So you have to divide this 100 divided by 20. So you will get 21 vanja and 25 ja 100. So 5 is here. So you can write 20 paise is 1/5 part of 1 rupee. Now next question we have. How many 10 paise will make 1 rupee? How many 10 paise? So you have to divide 100 divided by 10. So 10 vanja and 10 ja 100. You can also use your long division method. Okay, 10 vanja 10. Then you will cross it, then bring down 0. So 10 zeros are 0. So here you got 10. So you can write 10 paise is 1/10 part of 1 rupee. In this way you have solved this all questions. Now I want to tell you one more thing, that these all coins that you are looking, 20 paise, coins of 50 paise, 25 paise and also 10 paises, are banned by the Indian government. But before few years ago, all coins were legal in the market. Now in the next page we have an old woman's will. Yes, it is a very interesting story, and we have also some questions to solve this out. So first of all, read this story. So are you ready? Okay, let's start it. Once there lived an old woman. She lived with her 3 daughters. She was quite rich and had 19 camels. You have to know this, that she was very rich and 19 camels she had. And one day She fell ill. The daughters called the doctor. The doctor tried his best but could not save the woman. Now the woman is dead. After her death, the daughters read what she had written in her will. So here you can see the property is divided by that old woman among her three daughters. So first is, my eldest daughter will get half of my camels. So half of 19 camels, okay, half of camels. So this is, my second daughter will get 1/4 of my camels. So 1/4 of 19 camels. And my third daughter will get 1/5 of my camels, means 19. So here you have to find, here you have to divide half of 19, then half of 1/4 of 19, and 1/5 of 19. So is it possible that you will get half of 19 camels? No, it is not possible. So let's see what is happening. The daughters were really puzzled. Yes, it's a question of very confusing. How can I get half of 19 camels? Ask the eldest daughter. Half of 19 is 9 and half, but we cannot cut the camel. The second daughter said, yes, the second daughter is right. That is right, but what will we do now? Ask the third daughter. So they are all are thinking about it, that how they will divide the all camels. Just then they saw their auntie is coming. The daughters told her their problem. Show me the will, I have an idea. Now the auntie is saying, you take my camel, you so have 20 camels. Means three daughters have total 19 camels and auntie is giving her one camel. So total number of camel is 20 now. Next, you want half of the camels, don't you? Take 10 camels, she said to the eldest daughter. Yes, now they are dividing. How they are dividing? Half of, not 19, now they have 20. So what is half of 20? Yes, 10 camels. So the eldest daughter is getting 10 camels. Now take your share, the auntie told the second daughter. She took 1/4 of the camels and got dash camel. Now we have to find 1/4 of 20 camels. So 1/4 × 20, so you will get 5 camels. Now the second daughter is getting 5. Now you can take 1/5 of the camels, the auntie told the third daughter. So now we have to find 1/3 of 20. Sorry, 1/5. Sorry, 1/5 of 20 means 1/5 × 20. So the third is getting 4 camels. Means we found that first daughter got 10 camels, second got 5, and the third got 4 camels. Clear? And next, she got, here you can write 4 camels. The daughters were very happy and counted their camels now. So 10 plus 5 plus 4, total 19. Yes, yes, they all have a total 19 camels, and 19 camel was divided according to the bill. So in this way they divided this all. Now the one remaining is mine. Yes, one camel was remaining because total there were 20 camels, said the auntie, and took her camel away. So she took her one camel. Now next we have, how did this happen? Discuss. Actually it was very difficult to divide 19 camels among the three daughters. So just because the help of the auntie, it was possible to divide among the all daughters. Now we have the second topic, Arun's time table. So sleeping 1/3 of a day. 1/3 of a day means here you have to find, one day makes how many hours? So you all know one day makes 24 hours. Clear? So 1/3. So here you have to find 1/3 of 20. So you will get 8. So sleeping is here, means 8 hours is the timing of sleeping, and that is colored. Now next, use different colors to show. Okay, we will use it up. Playing 1/8 of a day. So here you have to find a solution. 1/8, So you can write 1 upon 8 into 24 hours. Why 24 hours? Because 1/8 of one day. One day makes 24 hours. So it is 3 hours. 8 1 ja and 8 3 ja 24. So she is getting 3 hours. And you can color in blue. Next we have studying. 1/4 of day. So you can find here 1 upon 4 into 24. So it is 4 6 ja 24. So 6 hour is the timing of studying. Clear? Now you can color it out. So first you have to note this all, that 3 hours is playing time and 6 hour is studying time. Clear? 3 and 6. So now you have to color it all. Sleeping, playing was 3 hours and studying was 6 hours and sleeping was 8 hours. Clear? 8, 6 and 3. So playing hours you have to color in blue. Here you can color it. So let me choose the color. For the sleeping it is already colored. For studying it is green color. So let me take the green, and green was 6 hours. So you have to choose 6 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you have to take the blue color. And the timing of playing hours was 3. So you can 1, 2 and 3. In this way you can color. Now how many hours is remaining here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Means total 7 hours is remaining here. Actually this is the whole 24 hours timing. And that is divided in playing, studying and others. So 7 hours is the remaining time for other activities. You have to know this. Now next, what part of the day does he use for other activities? We have already answered this. 7 hours for other activities. Now school magazine. So before going on school magazine, I want to tell you some conversion between the time, and that is one. We will start from the biggest. That is 1 year. So 1 year makes 365 days, and one leap year makes 366 days. Clear? Now you also know that 1 month makes 30 or 31 days, excepting February. Next, one day makes 24 hours. Clear? Then 1 hour makes 60 minutes, and 1 minute makes 60 seconds. Clear? You have to know this all, time conversion. Now in the next topic we have school magazine. This is our next topic. Let's start to read. School has decided to bring out a magazine every quarter of the year. So we have already discussed about it, that 1 year makes 365 days, but here we have to know that 1 year have 12 months. Clear? And every quarter means, what will be the quarter of 12? Yes, it is, you have to find this. Quarter means 1/4. So 1/4 into 12, it means 3 months. Okay, so every 3 months is the quarter of a year. For example, the month starts from January. So January, then February, then March. So March is the quarter month of the year. Clear? So we can say that 1 year has 4 quarters. Clear? Next we have, how many magazines will they have in 1 year? Yes, it is very simple. 1 year has 4 quarters. It means 4 magazines will be out in 1 year. If they want to print it at the end of quarter of a year, which are the months for printing? Mark the number of those months. So we have already discussed about it, that every 3rd month will be its quarter, and that we have to color it. So first here you can see that from 1 to 12 number is written for 12 months. So one number is for January, similarly second is for February, third is March, fourth is April, May, June, July, and similarly 11th is November and 12th is December. So we have to mark that 1/4 month. So first will be this one, third, then next will be 6 months, then 9, and at last 12th. Here 3rd is stand for March, 6 is for June, 9 is September, and last we have December. Next, yes, Sleeping Beauty. So let's start it. Have you heard of Kumbhakarna? Yes, it is a character of Ramayana, and you all have watched this epic serial Ramayana. The brother of Ravan, yes, you all know about also Ravan. He is famous for sleeping for half a year. It means Kumbhakarna slept 6 months of a year. Half means half of a year, means 6 months. Most people sleep about 8 hours a day. Yes, out of 24 hours, generally people sleep 8 hours. Then what part of day is it? So it is very easy. Means if a people is sleeping 8 hours out of 24, clear? So 8 upon 24. So it is how much? How much part? So 8 1 ja and 8 3 ja. So this is 1/3 part of a day. Means generally a people sleep 1/3 part of a day. Now next, so what part of a year do they sleep? A person 60 years old must have slept this year. So here is a question, that what part of a year do they sleep? If a person is sleeping 8 hours of one day, clear? So you have to find it, that in a whole year has how many days? 365 days, clear? So how many hours it is? So you can solve this question. For this, first you have to find the total hours of one year. Okay, for example, one day has 24 hours, clear? So one year has 365 days. Okay, an ordinary year has 365 days. So it has how many hours? So for that you have to multiply this. So 365 multiply by 24 hours, then you will get the total hours. So it will be 8760. So this is your total hours, okay, that you will divide. Now you have to find the total sleeping hours. Okay, as you all know that a person sleep 8 hours in one day. So in whole year, so for that you have to multiply 365 with 8 hours, clear? Because in one day people are sleeping 8 hours. So in 365 days, so 365 multiplied by 8, so it will be 2920, clear? Now we have our timings, so now we have to divide this. So for this, first you have to write the sleeping time, sleeping hours, that is 2920, okay, upon the total hours was 8760. Now you can divide this. Okay, so you will see that it is just 1/3. Okay, 2920 is 1/3 of 8760. You can also use your long division method. Okay, means 8760 and whole divided by 2920, then you will get that in third times it is easily dividing. For that I told you that 2920 is the third part of 8760. So we found that in a year people sleep it's 1/3 part, clear? So next question is, a person 60 years old must have slept this year. So once again we have to find 1/3 of 60 years. Okay, let's see that the old person whose age is 60 years, he has slept how many years of his life. So we can see that 3 2s and 3 0s, so 20 years. So if people sleep 20 years of his 60 years life. So in this way we have solved this all questions. You can try it all, and till then we have to over this class now. See you all in the next video. Stay at home, be healthy, and bye bye.